not be known to some of you, my name is Scott Sheldon. I'm a Presbyterian pastor ordained in the Presbyterian Church, and yet I have found a home here over the past 6 or so months. And the reason for that is that two members of this congregation, both of whom are here today, Adam and Alan, each spoke to me on the same week and invited me to come and visit. Neither one knew the other was extending that invitation. They came at me from different contexts, and I visited, and I have been back almost every week and have found a home here. Now, I have some good news and some maybe not so good news to share with you. First of all, let me simply say that you have provided me the home that I have needed over these past months. You have extended hospitality, and I have found this to be an incredible congregation. And week after week, I am just so inspired by the preaching, by the fellowship, by the care and concern that all of you in your own ways share with one another and certainly have shared with me. I have, over the course of my career, having once been an architect and having served churches and having served in executive roles within the Presbyterian Church, have had an opportunity to work with a number of congregations, probably hundreds of congregations, in helping to raise some funds. I currently am serving in the fundraising capacity. I had served as director of development at Princeton Theological Seminary for a number of years. So this has been home for a very long time. However, tomorrow morning, I leave for the West Coast, where I will be living and working for a period of about 9 months. I have been offered the position of vice president at San Francisco Theological Seminary to help them at a very critical time of transition in the life of that 141-year-old institution, just a little older than your congregation, to work with the outgoing interim president, welcome the incoming permanent president, helping them on a number of different fronts, including helping them to bring closure to their southern campus in Southern California, and also to help them in a spectacular transition and reformation of their campus in San Anselmo, which is just north of San Francisco. So that will be home. Part of our move happened yesterday. Part of it was playing out this morning. We have another piece of it playing out in another week or two. And that's all because we expect to be back. And so some things stay here, some things go with us, and some things probably disappear along the way. Who knows? So I just wanted to share with you a conversation that started just a few weeks ago with Stephen. I remember sitting here with you in worship when Stephen did what he probably did not want to do, which was to talk about money, to talk about some concern that was being realized in terms of the available funds that have dwindled over time, in part because of the recession, but simply because you are a smaller congregation and there are many expenses. I work with an organization called Partners for Sacred Places. I serve on their board, and one of the things we do is help to equip congregational leaders to raise funds for historic religious properties. It's one of the great joys of my life to be able to be part of that national organization. And so we tend to talk with congregations, especially their leadership, about ways to raise funds even beyond membership, because it's the membership that carries the burden typically. And yet, also very typically, many community groups use your facility. Many people who have once been members and now live a distance still care about your congregation and its mission and its ministry. And so Stephen invited me to have a conversation. We talked about how you as a congregation might be able to turn momentum around and begin to raise some funds. And so I shared some ideas with not only Stephen, but with her, and perhaps that word has started to spread. I wish Stephen would have been here this morning, because I would have enjoyed a little tag team with him, and I would have set the table, and he would have intended to be a way to focus some funds in particular, some extra giving opportunity funds, on your mission to feed more sheep. The way it's going to be different, it will not involve passing around the plate a second time. It will be an opportunity once a month on Communion Sunday to consider a gift to this particular fund, and it will be part of the liturgy of communion. One of the phrases in our call of worship this morning which stood out in my mind was, there is bread here to feed every need. There's bread here to feed every need. And even as we come to communion to be fed, there will be the opportunity to feed. And that's what our call as disciples of Jesus Christ, as followers of Jesus Christ, is all about. But it's not only you who will be asked to consider making a contribution. We are going, I say we. I keep saying we. We're going to look beyond membership of the church to other constituent groups, local businesses, friends of the congregation, former members of the congregation, even those who use the group, who use the building, different groups within the building. And that will be the opportunity to begin to build some momentum and to have the funds to advance your mission of feeding more sheep. So I'm a case in point. I won't be here with you week after week, as I wish I could be. But I have the opportunity to contribute to your mission, nonetheless. So even from the West Coast, I will feel a part of this congregation, not only in the ways in which I can give, but also in ways that I can somehow, or be in worship on Sundays, through the mysteries of technology, and feel as if there's a part of me that is still here. So when I do return, it'll feel like I haven't missed a week. So that's the small contribution that I bring to you and offer to you. And it will be very exciting. I was told just minutes ago that work is already underway on a sheep feeding trough, which will be front and center. Go figure. But it's, I'll just end on this note. What started this conversation was a comment I shared with Stephen, and that was one of our dear donors, Dean Arrigo, where I've been serving as their chief development officer. I know they raise sheep, they live up in Hopewell, and they've been very generous donors of our organization over time. And about 3 weeks ago, I picked up the phone and I called them and I said to the wife, Judy, I said, Judy, how do you feed sheep? I don't know, how do you feed sheep? And so she told me, and she provided me some resources. I didn't even know what she ate out of. And so she gave me some plans, and she gave me some photographs, and she shared her personal experience of raising sheep and how meaningful that is for her. And so she was very excited